the IFT of 2021, or should we say IFT 2020, happened on the 24th of Jan this year, and it was extremely similar to what it looked like in its previous version. So here we will do the analysis of the test in terms of the sections that were there, what could be the possible sectional cutoffs, and what could be the overall cutoff when it comes to the IFT. Now, if you look at the pattern of the test and the look and feel of the test, the interface, it was extremely similar to what it looked like in the 2019 version of it. So those of you who would have seen the test or who would have gone through the past IFT papers would have an edge over those of you who would not have seen those papers. So there was absolutely no change in terms of pattern. There was no change in terms of delivery. The same agency that had conducted the test in 2019 conducted it in 2021 as well. And so there was no surprise in terms of the interface, in terms of the look and feel of the questions, and in terms of the pattern. The number of sections remained 4, and this would have come across as a relief to those of you who would have been worried about the data interpretation section and the reading comprehension sections in general. So here, what you could have done is you could have sort of changed your strategy by a bit so that you would be solving the questions that would have been most rewarding in terms of marks earned per minute. So that was essentially the thing that would have tilted it in your favor. And so those of you who would have managed your time well and would have split it proportionately across the sections would have done a good job at this test. The number of questions again remained 110, and this split was also extremely similar to what it was like last year. The total duration of the test again remained 120 minutes, and that basically gave us an indication that you had to be a lot quicker compared to what you were when it came to, let's say, the CAT or the ZAT. So that way, it was sort of a speed test that also had a lot of roadblocks along the way. Now, the marks per correct response remained at 3 marks for the 3 sections of reading comprehension, verbal ability, quantitative ability, and data interpretation and logical reasoning. But for the general awareness section, the marks awarded per right answer were 1.4. But for the general awareness section, the marks awarded per correct response were 1.5. The negative marking scheme was 1/3 of the maximum marks that you could have got for every correct response. So for the sections of verbal ability, reading comprehension, quantitative ability, and data interpretation, logical reasoning, every incorrect response would have invited a negative of 1 mark, whereas for the general awareness section, the negative would have been minus 0.5 marks. Now, if you look at the overview of the entire test, this is basically what it looked like. So quantitative ability had 25 questions similar to last year's test, wherein the marks per question was 3 and the total marks for the section would have been 75. Now, it would have been a good strategy to allocate roughly 30 to 35 minutes for the section. So if you look at the overall split of the 120 minutes that you would have had, 1/3 of the 105 minutes that you should have allotted to the non-general awareness section would have been allotted to quant, and that would have given you the required number of marks in that section. When it came to the verbal ability and reading comprehension section, there were 35 questions in total. The marks per question remained at 3. The total number of marks was 105. Again, a sectional time limit of 30 to 35 minutes would have been good enough to sail through this section. Similarly, data interpretation and logical reasoning comprised of 30 questions, 3 marks per question, 90 would have been the maximum number of marks that you could have scored, and a good amount of time that you could have allocated to this section would have been 35 to 40 minutes. General awareness is more or less a binary section wherein either you know the answer or you don't know the answer. There is no process that is involved in going from the moment you read the question to the time when you come up with the answer. So that's why the amount of time that you would be spending on the section is relatively less or insignificant compared to what you would have spent on the other three sections. And so a rough allocation of 5 to 10 minutes would have been good enough to sail through the section. Now, we have to remember that when it comes to the IFT specifically, you have to clear your sectional cutoffs as well in addition to the overall cutoff. The sectional cutoffs are generally minimal, and you can say that they are roughly around the 50th percentile, so to say. But then again, if you do not cross the overall cutoff, then you would not end up getting a point. So that's why you had to allocate at least some amount of time to each of these sections so that you could have cleared the bare minimum sectional cutoffs. Now, if you look at the expected cutoffs for each of the sections and the overall cutoff, as a whole, from the reports that we have got from students and mentors alike, it was definitely more difficult compared to what it looked like last year. So last year, or in IFT 2019, if you looked at the entire test, there were a lot of questions that could have been classified as easy or moderate. And although it was the first time that IFT went computer based, a lot of people were pleasantly surprised with the level of difficulty of the test. Because the IFT of 2017 and 2018, both the tests were relatively more difficult compared to an average IFT. So considering that entire thing, what we can say this year is that the cutoff is almost definitely going to be less compared to what it was like in IFT 29. At a sectional level, if you look at it, quantitative ability, we are expecting the cutoff to be roughly 10 to 12 marks. So you should have attempted a bare minimum of 4 questions to sort of clear at least the sectional cutoff. When it comes to the verbal ability and reading comprehension section, similar to what it was like last year, a couple of passages were doable, and the verbal ability section in terms of grammar and jumbled paragraphs was again something that could have been managed. So we are expecting the sectional cutoff for verbal ability and reading comprehension to be somewhere around 33 to 36 marks. Similarly, data interpretation and logical reasoning, wherein logical reasoning was the one that would have brought some respite to the candidates, we are expecting the cutoff to be somewhere around 18 to 20 marks, which will mean an absolute attempt of 6 to 7 correct questions. And the general awareness cutoff would remain more or less similar to what it looked like last year. So again, we are expecting 6 to 7 marks or 4 to 5 questions that you would have marked correctly. Now again, as I have already mentioned at the beginning of the video, you have to clear the sectional cutoffs, but that does not translate into you clearing the overall cutoff. The sectional cutoffs have traditionally been significantly lower compared to the overall cutoff. And so if you want to clear the test, or you want to get a call from the IFTs, then you have to hit your overall cutoff. And that, we are predicting, is going to be somewhere in the range of 125 to 130 marks, which was 138 last year. So compared to last year, we are expecting a drop by a good 5 to 6%. Coming to the data interpretation and logical reasoning section, the sectional difficulty can be classified as being medium to difficult. So IFT has been traditionally known to have data interpretation sets which involve a lot of calculation. The options are also very close, and that makes life difficult when you are tackling this entire section. And it remained true this year as well. So if you look at the data interpretation side of things, there were 4 sets that were present, each of which had 4 questions. There was a set that was based on line graph and bar on average sales, which was of medium to difficulty level. Then there was a bar graph and a line based chart that was present, which was considered to be the most difficult of the sets that was present in this year's IFT. The table based one was probably the one that should have been attempted. It was of moderate level of difficulty, whereas the pie chart plus table was a sitter and should have been attempted. So if you would have invested roughly 10 minutes or 15 minutes on this side of the LRDI section, then you could have attempted 1 or 2 sets out of the 4 that we have written. Now, if you look at the logical reasoning side of things, there were some sets that were present, and then there were some standalone questions that were present. If you look at it from the perspective of sets, there was one set on circular arrangement that had 4 questions, and it can be classified as being medium to difficult. So out of the 3 sets that we had, we could say that this was the one that was the most difficult. There was another set that was based on tournaments that was slightly tricky, and it had 4 questions, can be considered to be of moderate level of difficulty, especially if you were very comfortable with tournament logic based questions. And then there was one set that was based on scheduling, which had 2 questions, again it was of moderate level of difficulty. So again, this kind of a pattern remained similar to what it was like in IFT 2019. And the level of difficulty can also be said to be more or less on similar lines compared to what IFT 2019 looked like. The standalone questions that were present in logical reasoning were the easiest ones that were present. And so if you had to clear the sectional cutoff at a bare minimum level, it was almost mandatory that you should have attempted these questions. So there were 4 questions that were present. Linear arrangement based question, there was 1 question on coding, there were a couple of questions on puzzles. And all these questions can be classified to be of easy to medium level of difficulty, and so should have been attempted or should have been prioritized over the data interpretation sets that were present. Now, a good attempt in this section, especially if you want to clear the overall cutoff as well, would be somewhere around 12 to 14 questions, and that would be dominated by the logical reasoning side of things. So out of the 14 questions that you had from logical reasoning, it would have been especially rewarding if you could have solved roughly 8 to 10 questions from there, plus a couple of sets from data interpretation would have done the trick in this particular section. Coming to the second section that we had, reading comprehension and verbal ability, the sectional difficulty was again medium to difficult. It was almost a replica of IFT 2019. What changed was the length of passages in a couple of occasions. So there were four passages that were present, each comprising of four questions. And so the section remained extremely similar to what it has been like for the last decade. The length of the passages made the difference here, because there were a couple of passages that were relatively shorter and a couple of passages that were longer in terms of the length that was present. Now, one thing that you had to keep in mind in this particular section was that there was a bit of horizontal scrolling also that was involved. So if someone would have expanded the question screen and would have hidden the response tab, then you would have been able to go through the entire passage in a seamless manner. But a lot of people face difficulty scrolling horizontally and vertically, which was again the case in the last IFT as well. And that would have sort of irritated some of the test takers. Now, the passages that were present were not very difficult to read and understand, but the length of the passages would have made a difference, and also the nature of questions would have made a difference. So a lot of questions were based on fact checking. So you had to understand which one of the options was the true statement or which one of the options was the false statement. And that takes a lot of time, even if you are just skimming through the entire passage. So if you look at the passages, the easiest passage was probably the one that was based on plastic packaging and sort of the pollution and the economic costs of replacing the plastic packaging that exists. Right? It was a very short passage. There were four specific detailed questions that were present, and that could have been classified as the easiest of the four passages. Again, not very difficult to spot because of its length. Then, influence of culture on the economy was the other passage that was shorter in nature. Again, there were two questions that were based on specific details, and one was inferential. Again, this was a passage that could have been prioritized over the other passages because it comprised of easy to moderate questions. The two longer passages were also the more difficult passages and so could have been avoided. So there was a passage on the effects of social influence on human beings. There was a passage on Obama versus the liberals or Obama and the liberals versus conservative divide. So again, fairly interesting passages if I were to add. But then again, from an exam perspective, it would have made sense if you could have skipped these passages. Coming to the verbal ability side of things, IFT has always had an interesting verbal ability section, and even this year it remained the same. There were questions that were based on crossword. There were questions that were based on vocabulary, synonyms, match the following, root words. So there were questions that were based on different aspects of vocabulary. And for someone who would have prepared specifically for vocabulary or who would have had a strong hold on vocabulary, that person could have sailed through this entire section, because verbal ability traditionally does not take a lot of time to go through the entire thing, right? And considering that each question was giving you as many marks as it would have given you in the context of reading comprehension, I think something like this could have been prioritized, especially if you had a strong hold on vocabulary. Now, if you look at the number of questions and the split that was present, you can see a lot of questions are easy or medium in nature. So you can easily see that there were two easy questions on match the synonyms, four easy questions on root word synonyms, two easy questions on grammatically incorrect sentences, three easy questions on one word substitution, and one easy jumbled paragraph. So there were a lot of easy questions that were spread throughout this part of reading comprehension and verbal ability. And so it would have made a lot of sense if you'd have gone through these questions quickly. So as we said, the sectional cutoff is expected to be somewhere around 33 to 36 marks. but the number of attempts that you would have to make so as to stand a good chance of clearing the overall cutoff would have been 18 to 20 with a good accuracy of roughly 85%, right? So an absolute attempt of 20 questions with 17 or 18 right answers would have given you a very strong score in this particular section. Having said that, if you compare this with last year's IFT, you would see that this was slightly difficult compared to the last year's IFT, wherein people liberally scored 70, 75 marks in that section. So that way, this is going to be slightly low scoring compared to what it was like last year. The general awareness section is again something that has remained fairly consistent across IFTs. There is no one genre that has dominated the section. So if you are a specialist in something, it will not really reward you as handsomely as you might like. So what happened in this year's general awareness was the entire section was again moderate in terms of level of difficulty. There were 20 questions. The marks per question was less compared to what it was for the other sections. Normal MCQs and match the following questions made an appearance. So two column questions wherein you have to match the items in one column with those in the other column. So that remained consistent. The split between the static and the current affairs questions was also more or less balanced with 9 questions from static GK and 11 questions that were based on current affairs. So someone who would have been well read would have been able to attempt 8 to 10 questions easily with 60 to 70% accuracy. And if you would have gone through the IFT preparation video that I had done a few days before the test, again, the strategy of attempting more would have rewarded you in terms of general awareness, specifically because the options were not very close again. So someone who would have taken some risks in the general awareness section would have found that cushion of 5 or 6 marks that would eventually make the difference in the final convert as well. Coming to the most challenging section of this year's IFT, it's quantitative ability, and this surprised a lot of people. So last year, or in IFT of 2019, the quantitative ability section was difficult but doable. This year, the quantitative ability section was sort of a nightmare. And those of you who would have gone to the test, considering QA to be their strongest part, would have been surprised because it was not exactly a very high scoring section. And people, out of desperation, would have invested some time in solving more math questions than they should have, which would have led to an eventual downfall. So this was arguably the toughest and the most time consuming section of the 4 that we had this year. The split was not very off from what exactly used to happen earlier. So there were 11 questions from arithmetic out of 25, which is roughly what, 44% of the total number of questions that we had. 5 questions on geometry, 4 questions on algebra. So even if you were comfortable with 3 out of the 5 topics that we have here, you would have been able to make sense of 80% of the test. But making sense of the test is one part of the deal. The other thing is to actually sit and solve these questions, right? And that was where the difficulty level came into the picture. There were some questions that involved multiple concepts bundled into one, time and work, time, speed, distance bundled into one, let's say, for example. There were questions that had a horrible number of lines that you had to go through. So 7 or 8 line questions, right? Again, that has been the style of IFT. And typically in a difficult quantitative ability section at the IFT, you will always see these kind of things happening. The options will be very close. There'll be multiple topics that will be present. The entire question will be presented to you in the form of a story, meaning that you will have to read through that entire thing, be patient and solve the question, which is not exactly something that we are looking at when we have to go through 110 questions in 120 minutes, right? So IFT quantitative ability section stayed true to the level of difficulty that is expected. And it was slightly more difficult compared to what it was like in the last edition of IFT. A good number of attempts would be 9 to 10 questions. So if you can see the classification, there were 12 questions that can be classified as easy. But the challenge was in identifying these 12 questions and keeping your calm when you are going through the other 13 questions. So those of you who would have managed this particular thing would have easily got roughly 25 to 30 marks in this particular section. So a number of attempts that would sort of make you a bit proud would be 9 to 10 questions in this particular section. Overall, if you look at it, the pattern remained more or less the same. The interface remained more or less the same. The experience remained more or less the same. So IFT has always been a test for which the best way to prepare is by going through the past papers. And those of you who would have gone through the past 10-year papers from your IMS resources tab would have done a good job at the test. So there were tabs for different sections in terms of the interface, and there was a question palette that was present, and you could sort of navigate through questions without any sectional time limits. So that was consistent. A number of questions required vertical as well as horizontal scrolling. So it sometimes happens at the NMAT, wherein you have to scroll horizontally as well as vertically. And at the NMAT specifically, it required you to access the entire area before you could move to the next question. Thankfully, there was no such problem in this test. But then again, scrolling horizontally and vertically, especially if your mouse does not have a wheel that has been enabled, it makes a big difference, right? So that is basically what a lot of people found to be distracting. And again, if you would have kept your wits around this particular thing, then I think you would have done a good job. Hiding the question palette, again, this is basically an advice for future takers. In case you come across this kind of a situation, there are a couple of things that you might want to explore. One is hiding the question palette. And the other thing is viewing your entire question paper in the form of a PDF or using the view question paper option. So those of you who would have explored these two options and would have looked at the entire question in one go would have probably benefited by a bit. But again, this cannot be said to be a game changer. At the end of it, the person who would have solved the most questions would definitely win. But you could have used this particular thing, especially for DI. So overall, again, if I were to summarize the entire thing, IFT 2021 was consistent with what we have come to expect of IFT. It was slightly more difficult compared to the last IFT that was conducted. But considering that people were more mentally prepared to deal with a computer-based IFT, they would have also gone through the past IFT papers and would have been sort of prepared in terms of expectation when it came specifically to the quantitative ability and the data interpretation sections, we are expecting the cutoff to be somewhere around 125 to 130 marks. Hope you guys have done well at the test. Stay tuned for more such analysis and more such prep related videos. Keep preparing, stay safe, and thank you for watching this video.